So, we're going to talk about this morning, if you will permit it, why is it that we human beings who have lived on this earth for over a million years or more, why we have become what we are? Brutal, violent, killing each other in the name of God, in the name of country. In the name of peace. There used to be a slogan after the First World War which said, this war, like the next war, is to end all wars. And this repetitive process of killing each other has been going on. Though we are highly educated, technologically extraordinarily efficient, but psychologically we are very, very primitive. And we were saying, why is it that we do not change? Why is it that there is no end to all this terrible individualistic, competitive drive which is destroying the world? And why is it pleasure has become so extraordinarily important in the world? Whole entertainment industry, so-called sports, and the, if you forgive also, the religious entertainment, which is considered sacred. These are the various forms of pleasure. Someone asks, is love a movement, an endless movement of pleasure? Is love attachment? Attachment to a belief, to a concept, to knowledge, to a person, or to a symbol? One is attached to the country, to the flag, as everyone in the world is doing that. The separative, symbolic flag. Asiatics have their own flags to which they are terribly attached, as in this country, for which you are willing to kill each other, which is what is happening now. And we say, that's a principle. A principle that a country which has become aggressive must be push back, and so we are willing to kill others. This has been the old repetition from the most ancient of days. And every religion, the most ancient ones and the recent ones of 2000 years, always said love, do not kill. Someone master. If one is at all serious in our relationship to each other, man and woman, the relationship with the rest of humanity, whether they're black, white or purple or whatever color they be, in that relationship, why is there so much conflict? So we ought to inquire very deeply, as we said, can all the things which are false, like pride, arrogance, attachment and the desires, pleasures and so on, which obviously are not love, can all that end?